Hey everyone, in this video we will learn how to create a data analysis template in Python. So we'll use a nested dictionary variable for this. Let's start. I've got a file here with me and I've also uploaded this file to GitHub. I'll leave a link to the file in the video notes so you can download the file and use it for your projects. The dataset I'm using, I'll leave a link to the dataset in the video notes as well so you can download the dataset should you want to. So a lot of times where I want to do is I want to do standard data analysis functions on numerical variables. And we learn how to build a template using the nested dictionary variable. Let's start. So all I'm doing in the first step is I'm importing pandas, I'm importing matplotlib, and then I'm getting the data into the data frame from wherever it's sitting in my machine. So I'll hit shift enter and this one gets executed. Then I'll just print the top five records. So that's all I'm doing here, just to have a look at what my data frame or data set looks like. And now let's say, so a lot of times I want to, for numerical variables, I have a set pattern where I want to see a certain things, what's the mean, what's the median, what's the standard deviation, or what's the range, what's the minimum value, what's the maximum value. So you could create a, so we learn how to create a nested dictionary variable. And we learn how to just use that. So let's start. So I'm creating a variable called DA, and all I'm saying is in DA, I'm saying age, I'm getting mean, median, max, min, and range. So I'm saying for the age variable, which is this, I'll just create a variable DA, which is, for me, it's data analysis. So I'll hit shift enter. And then I'm doing a DF, which is the data frame dot group by, and I'm saying gender. And I'm saying aggregate, so by gender, show me the mean, median, age range, and so on and so forth. So I'll show you, this is fairly powerful. And it's giving me mean age, median age. You can also do the same thing, but you can use a, maybe you want to do it on passenger class. So I was, let's see. So it'll give us all the data analysis for the numerical variables by passenger class. So I'll hit shift enter and showing me the mean age, median age, max age, min age by passenger class. Let's say I've got another numerical variable here, which is fare. So I want to include that in as well. It's fairly easy. All I do is I'll copy this, what I've created. I'll just add a comma here. And in place of age, I will just put in fare. Mean fare, median fare, max fare, min fare, and fare range. So let's change this. So I'm going to hit shift enter now and it's gotten created. Now we'll do a analysis on the categorical variable for age and fare. So let me hit shift enter. And you can see it's giving me the, by gender, it's giving me the data analysis for age and fare. Similarly, I can do a data analysis for passenger class. And I'll do it, so let me hit shift enter and it'll become clear. So it's giving me the age, mean age, median age, max age, min age, and age range for different passenger class. And similarly for different passenger class, it's giving me the mean fare, median fare, max fare, min fare, and then the fare range. So this one is a quick one where you can pretty much just save a standard template for data analysis. And all you need to do is replace or add more variables, whatever is your column name for numerical variables. And then you can quickly do analysis by different categorical variables. So I hope you find this video useful. In this video, we've learned to build nested dictionary variable and then use that as a data template to analyze our data. So that's about it. I hope you find this video useful and thanks for watching this video. Please do subscribe to my channel and like my videos if you enjoy what I'm doing. Please do let me know if you would like me to take up any specific video or you've got certain queries. Cheers, bye.